Hi, and welcome to this video, where we will show you how to install an Emaldo power system. We will go through the following: introduction and safety, product overview and installation, operation and troubleshooting. This guide is tailored to assist installers in executing the installation efficiently and safely, ensuring that all procedures are followed correctly for optimal performance of any of the Emaldo power systems. Please keep in mind that the installation guide is a supplementary resource, and we strongly advise you to read the entire installation guide before installing any Emaldo power system. To begin, make sure to choose the right installation location, which allows for enough free space on all sides of any Emaldo power system, except for the backside, which must be secured to the wall. Now you can move the package to the chosen installation spot and unpack it. Carefully inspect the outer packaging for visible damage, such as holes, cracks, or any indicators of potential internal issues. After that, take a moment to inspect the accessories in the package. Make sure everything matches the packing list. Before starting the installation, gather all the necessary protective gear and tools. Let's begin the installation. First, level the whole location using a leveling instrument. Next, mark the spots with a marker. Then take an electric drill and create installation holes for the M6 bolts at the marked points. Align the cabinet with these holes. Gently tap the expansion bolts into the wall holes with a hammer. Now install the nuts, making sure to include the flat washers. Finally, use a wrench to securely tighten the nuts. Now let's move on to installing the batteries and the inverter. Remove the rubber protection only from the sections where the power boxes will be installed. Securely grip the handle of the power box with both hands. Align the power box with the slide-on guide rails in the cabinet. Make any necessary adjustments to its position and push it into place. Finally, turn the safety lock on both sides of the power box to secure it in place. Proceed to install the second and third power box, along with the inverter, in a bottom-up sequence, using the same method. Ensure you firmly push each component into place, making sure the power boxes and inverter are securely and fully connected to the unit. Let's move on to the electrical connection. Start by opening the side door of the unit and carefully removing the stickers. Keep in mind that the connectors for each Emaldo power system may vary slightly. For the Emaldo power core, only remove the stickers for the exact number of MPPT strings you'll be using. Begin by unscrewing the side plate. Continue by wiring the RJ45 smart meter communication cable into the Y splitter labeled with meter. You also have the option to connect an Ethernet cable by using the LAN port on the Y splitter. Ensure the wiring is identical on both ends of the cable at the RJ45 plugs. Once done, connect the cable to the COM port on the Emaldo power system. The communication cable between the Emaldo system and the smart meter is 5 and 6 in the Emaldo system to 21 and 22 in the smart meter. 5 always goes to 21 and 6 to 22. We recommend using a Cat6 shielded cable or better. For further details, refer to the user manual provided with the smart meter. The communication cable between the Emaldo system and the CT meter is 5 and 6 in the Emaldo system to 21 and 22 in the CT meter. We recommend again using a Cat6 shielded cable or better. In the CT meter, an arrow will indicate the direction of electricity flow into the system. Make sure the arrow points towards the incoming consumption. Each wire must have its own CT clamp. Connect the CT clamps to the smart meter, A1 to A1, B1 to B1, and so on. For more details on the smart meter, please refer to the manual. Next, let's move on to assembling the grid connector. Begin by installing the threaded part and threading the wire through the front shell. Guide the wire into the needle hole, then secure it by tightening the 5 slotted screws on the side. Once you've successfully assembled the grid connector, it's time to plug it into the grid port on the Emaldo power system. The Emaldo KeepON 24/7 power backup kit is an optional product. Includes everything you need to enable true power backup of all of your most important appliances and loads. With this installed, power backup will automatically kick in within milliseconds, ensuring no downtime on the connected loads. The Emaldo KeepON backup system is perfect for powering essential devices like critical electronics, security systems, refrigeration, and many more during power cuts. The Emaldo power core and power store units deliver continuous AC backup with a capacity of up to 10,800 watts and a peak of 21,600 watts. For a detailed description and more information, please refer to the installation manual. The next step is not applicable to the Emaldo power pulse. Let's connect the main AC connector to the flex port on the Emaldo power core or store. For the Emaldo power core and power store, repeat the same assembly steps as with the grid connector, but this time for the flex port. Start by installing the threaded part, threading the wire through the front shell, guiding it into the needle hole, and securing it by tightening the 5 slotted screws on the side. Once you've successfully assembled the grid connector, it's time to plug it into the flex port on the Emaldo power system. When connecting or disconnecting PV cables, remember to always switch off the system. Also, for safety, always measure the voltage and polarity on each pair. Please note, we've seen some installations of the Emaldo systems where the MPPT cable insulation has not been cut correctly, resulting in short circuits because the cable is not able to connect correctly. If the insulation is not properly cut, you will need to cut it as the picture below. After assembling all the necessary cables, it's time to screw the side plate back in place. The next step is to switch on the Emaldo power system. Open the cover plate on the right side of the Emaldo system, then press and hold the power button until the display lights up. Wait for the system to initiate. Once you see the phone icon on the display, you can continue setting up the system using the Emaldo app. If you are setting up a power store or pulse, please wait for the commissioning sound, which comes after approximately 1 minute. Once the Emaldo system is switched on, ensure all the batteries are connected and flashing. When the phone icon appears on the display, scan the QR code to set up the system. The final step, after setting up the system in the Emaldo Pro app, is to cover the Emaldo system with the front cover and secure it using the small screws provided. Optional battery expansion cabinet. The battery storage capacity of the Emaldo power core and Emaldo power store can be extended up to a maximum of 143 kilowatt hours. This expansion is accomplished by integrating up to 5 battery expansion cabinets, each capable of housing up to 5 Emaldo power boxes. Let's take a look at the connection of the Emaldo expansion cabinet. Ensure that there is enough free space around the entire system and all Emaldo units are properly leveled. For installations with battery expansion cabinets, it's recommended to position the Emaldo power core or power store on the right side of the designated installation area. This setup makes it easier to expand the battery cabinets on the left side. The 1 meter expansion cables are housed in the expansion cabinet. Let's start by connecting the expansion cabinet. Begin by unscrewing the bottom plate to access and connect the expansion cabinet cables. Pop out the rounded cutouts on the plate and remove all the rubber plugs covering the connection points. Connect each cable to the corresponding connection port. Start with the red cable, then proceed with the communication cable, and finish with the black cable. Remember to securely fasten the communication cable and ensure that both the red and black cables click into place. After assembling all the necessary cables, it's time to screw the bottom plate back in place. Let's move on to placing the power boxes into the expansion cabinet. Remove the rubber protection only from the sections where the power boxes will be installed. Ensure the rubber protection remains in place where no battery boxes will be added. When installing the power boxes, remember to firmly push them into the cabinet. Add as many batteries as needed, always starting from the bottom. Once completed, secure the system lid and screw it in for safety. Congratulations on a successful installation. You're all set and ready to go. For more in-depth information and detailed instructions, please visit our support page at emaldo.com, where you'll find all the latest materials and resources.